We're on Perek Yud, Mishnah Aleph, above Metzia. First Mishnah, last chapter above Metzia. We're going to talk about a case of a bayit va'aliyah. Bayit basically means a house on the first floor. Aliyah means a loft, the second floor. So basically what happened is two people have bayit va'aliyah shel shnayim. They're separately owned. One person owns the ground floor, and one person owns the aliyah. One person owns the upper floor. Shenaflu, and the whole house fell down. So what happens with what's left, with the building material? Remember, the building material, they had to rebuild. The stones were worth a lot. The materials were worth a lot. Says the Mishnah, Shneihem chokim ve'etzim uve'avanim uve'afar. They split the etzim, the wood, the stones, and the dirt. Ve'ro'im, that makes sense, because you don't know what belongs to whom. Ve'ro'im ilu avanim ha'ruyot lishtaber. They say, which are the stones that are ruyot lishtaber? Potential to break. What does that mean? Says the Bar Tudor, you have to look at how the house fell down. Because how the house fell down will tell you half of the stones broke. The house fell. The house collapsed. So some of the stones broke, and some of the stones are still intact. So the Bar Tudor says, Im nechbat habayit miyisodo. So if the house collapsed on its foundation, I mean the bottom house collapsed, ben afal tachtav, and the loft fell under it, and it fell, meaning the whole thing collapsed down. You have to know that the bottom stones broke. And therefore, the ones that are left belong to the upper guy. But if the top of the wall fell, like spread out, then the top ones broke. Because they fell from a very high place. And then the lower ones are complete. So then they fell from a low place. Meaning, you look at the blast radius, the way it fell, and you say, listen, if it fell far away, that means that the upper one's broken. If it fell like down inside of itself, that means the lower one's broken, and then the upper guy gets his rocks. But what about the ratio that says they split it? Meaning, first you say shneihem chokim, and then you say, that's different. Those are two different things. Which is it? Do they split it? Or do we see which rocks broke? So he says the resha, when it says they both split it, it must be talking about a case where it fell and then they removed the debris immediately. So you don't know. You don't know which one happened. Did it fall? Did it collapse under itself? Or it fell down with a clap? You can't tell. So if you don't know, then chokim. If you do know, you have to look and see, because that's the rules. If your house is the one that collapsed and your rocks are no longer worth it, why should you split it with the other? Why should the other guy split it with you? And if one of them recognizes some of his stones, notlam, he takes them, and then they're splitting the rest. If you don't know, so if you don't really know, you gotta say, oh, that's my balcony or whatever. Okay, he could take them. But then it counts from the rest of the rocks that they're splitting amongst each other. Okay, we'll dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman, and we'll stop here. Have a good day.